Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 4.2 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abaqus. In this example, we go much further than example 4.1. Using example 4.1b as a starting point, we use the external software called BMIE.out to calculate the eigenvalue, capital lambda. Furthermore, we can get the slope of the secondary path, which is zero in this case, and the curvature of the secondary path, which is positive in this case. Look in the textbook for their practical meaning. First, open the CAE file from example 4.1.b and save it as x4.2.cae. Since most of the model is taken from example 4.1.b, we go directly to meshing, to make a coarse mesh that will solve faster. Next we edit the step, to allow even more iterations than before. Now we create node sets, at the corner nodes, at inter-element nodes, and at mid-side nodes. These sets are needed to enter the edges load in terms of nodal loads, because that is the only way to specify the load for BMIE.3. Now we delete the edge loads because BMIE.3 does not understand them, and we re-enter them in terms of equivalent, concentrated loads at the nodes, following the 1646 rule, as explained in the textbook. Now we set up a new job, and we run it, to have CAE write an abaqus.inp file, that we need for BMIE.3. From the results, let's check the eigenvalues. The first eigenvalue is 213. So, the buckling load is 213 times the applied reference load. Now open the work directory with File Explorer. Double-click the file imp2bmi3.exe, which converts the Abaqus input file, job-1.inp, into bmi3.inp, which is the input file for BMIE3. It also writes ABQ.in, which is a filtered version of job-1.inp, that can be executed with Abaqus to verify that the file conversion went well. Now we run ABQ.inp, as a new job in Abaqus. In this way, we verify that the conversion went well. Also, we learn how to run an Abaqus job directly from an INP file, rather than from a model. Looking at the results from abq.inp, the eigenvalue is 213, which is correct, and the mode, as seen by the deformation and contour plot, is also correct. That means that the conversion went well, and so, we can run BMIE3 now. In File Explorer, double-click BMIE3.exe, to execute the buckling mode interaction software. The number 3 in BMIE3, means that up to 3 modes are considered by the software for buckling mode interaction. We do not calculate interaction in this example, but interaction is what allows accurate predictions of imperfection sensitivity, if you wish to look further into this fascinating subject. You don't have to copy the results from the computer screen. They are saved to BMIE3.out. If we scroll down, we find the 5 lower eigenvalues, and the lowest is -210, which is fine, and the slope L1, almost 0, and the curvature L2 is -0.75, which means the post-buckling path is stiffening. This is good, because stiffening post-buckling means the structure is insensitive to imperfections, at least in the vicinity of the bifurcation. Further away, who knows, modes may interact, and that may mean imperfection sensitivity, which wouldn't be good for safety. Okay, that's it for today. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook, by following the link in the description. Thank you.